I still remember when I heard you call me by name. I'd follow you anywhere, knew I could trust you in anything. But now sorrow beats down on me, waiting for you to come through. I'm all alone with my questions, I'm dry and cracked open, I thirst for you. And as I fall apart, come flood this desert heart. Fall like the rain, living water. And I know your way. Seems so out of control. Nail-scarred hands tell the story of love that will never let go of me. Through the sunshine or rain, I know where my hope is found. What you started in me, I know you will complete from the inside. And as I fall apart, come flood this desert heart. Fall like the rain, living water. And I know your way is best. Lord, help me find my rest. And I'll be the clay in the hands of the potter. Is shaping me, and now the enemy is afraid of what you're making me. When my world is breaking me, your love is shaping me, and now the enemy is afraid of what you're making me. My world is breaking me. Your love is shaping me. And now the enemy is afraid of what you're making me. And as I fall apart, come flood this desert heart.
And simultaneously, a picture was shown together with the pictures of six other holy saints high above St. Peter's Square, while the whole world, with gratitude and wonder, watched it. The exemplary life, the image and the name of this ordinary woman from the Westerwald, Germany, and our sister in faith is now known and recommended to all for veneration. One of the precious fruits of the canonization is that now she is a gift to the entire church. She does not anymore belong to only poor handmaids. Now I look at her with a new perspective and vision, and her quotes generate new meaning. She has insights for everybody. Her writings speak volumes to the readers of any time. She was so humble and simple. Being canonized was nowhere near the bucket list. One of the poor handmaids said she would not have wanted this for herself, but she would accept it for the church. What makes her sacred is that she did every ordinary thing with heart full of love for God. She writes, "The good God does not demand extraordinary things from us, but we give Him all of our heart." Every single morning, this woman put on her shoes to set off for the work, get going and change. Katharina did truly understand Jesus. Certainly, this was not always easy, and it is not easy even today. With her life, she gives us an example and instruction. We recognize the closeness to the poor that Pope Francis noted about her. Her passion to risk everything, her willingness to leave all behind, so that her heart had room totally for her God. Dear bishops, reverend fathers, sisters, friends and well-wishers, once again, I wish and pray may this festivities of Eucharist strengthen us to follow in Katharina's footsteps better every day. Welcome.
Spoke a word, you were singing over me. You have been so, so
for the congregation and for all of us. We have heard about our life, about our virtues, about our simplicity and care for the poor. I did not know them.
Great wonders, who fosters our growth from birth
and deals with us according to His mercy. May He give us gladness of heart, and may there be peace in our days, in Israel as in the days of old. May He entrust to us His mercy, and may He deliver us in our days. The word of the Lord.
The challenge that we have for us is, in what way
do we answer the call today, the cry of the people who are around us? And this cry is different type. The poor spiritually, materially, socially, emotionally, and many other ways. Third, Holy Father says that we should be free to free them. In the Bible, the poor live in security that God intervenes on their behalf to restore their dignity. Poverty is not something that anyone desires, but is caused by selfishness, pride, greed, and injustice. God's act of liberation is a saving act for those who lift up to Him their sorrows of and distress. The bondage of poverty is shattered by the power of God's intervention. God's salvation is a hand held out to the poor, a hand that welcomes, protects, enables them to experience the friendship they need. From this concrete and tangible proximity, genuine path of liberation emerges. Each individual Christian and every community is called to be an instrument of God for the liberation of the poor and for enabling them to be fully part of the society. Holy Father says, this demands that we be docile and attentive to the cry and to become come to their aid. This is the call that we have made when we celebrate this Thanksgiving Mass and reflect on the life of Saint Maria Katharina Kasper. May Saint Katharina Kasper intercede for us. May her life be an example for us that we too may become concerned of the poor, the needy and the sick. And we too may give our helping hand to everyone who needs and looks for our help. Now, the prayers of the faithful on this happy day and joyful day, let us now raise our hearts and minds to God in the thanking God and interceding through Saint Katharina Kasper for all our needs.
walking around these walls. I thought by now they'd fall, but you.
Let me take this precious moment to thank our Heavenly Father for the grace granted to us during the Eucharistic celebration on this day of Thanksgiving. On behalf of the poor handmaids of Jesus Christ, PHJC associates and volunteers, I would like to express my heartfelt, sincere thanks to each of you for your presence among us. Thank you for your prayers with us and for us. For this day is sacred to all poor handmaids and followers of Catholic. On this special occasion, first I would like to share that how fortunate we poor handmaids were to have His Grace Most Reverend Bishop Emeritus Bernard Morris on October 14 in Rome, and also for the Thanksgiving celebration for all the Katharina's pilgrims on October 15 in St. Loyola Church, St. Ignatius of Loyola in Rome. So we thank you for that big opportunity that we had to be with you, His Grace. Today our joy is doubled for soliciting the Eucharist with great joy and profound love, respect for our foundress, St. Katharina Kasper. We feel honored to listen to your insightful sermon highlighting on the life history, the growth of the congregation, and the outstanding characteristics of our Mother Katharina Kasper. We express our love and appreciation with a shawl and memento to our dear bishop, who is closely associated with the poor handmaids for several years, ever since we are here. To have the noble personality and our honorable guest, Right Reverend Joseph Cornegam, the Bishop of Manandavadi, present with us. Dear Bishop, despite your busy schedule, you have availed yourself to join us in this Thanksgiving celebration. Thank you, Your Grace, for your special love and support towards poor handmaids, mission and ministry, very specially to care for the destitute women in Manandavadi Diocese. As a token of our love and gratitude to you, we would like to welcome you with a shawl and memento. By sharing our memento on this occasion to each of you.
The congregation of the four handmaids of Jesus Christ and our sisters especially the panel group who worked for the canonization, and all the people who worked for the canonization of St. Katharina Kasper. So, once again, I thank you one and all. Thanks to you God. Thank you.
Promise still stands. Great is your faithfulness. I never will forget.